Hello everyone, and in this video we will be talking about Google Trends and of course how you can use this tool to find profitable niche, to get some sales, and of course it will be mostly about print-on-demand business. This video will be mostly about that, about using Google Trends for finding a good idea for print-on-demand designs, but also you can use Google Trends to find any trending searches, and it can be implemented in any kind of the business. So let's start with Google Trends, like a tool. What is it and how to use it? In simple words, Google Trends help you to find what is popular right now and to see the graph of popularity. For example, if we will look for a Mediterranean diet trend for the last 5 years, we can see that here were some spikes when this diet was very popular, and this graph is from 0 to 100, where 100 is a time when this search was the most popular. As for Mediterranean diet, it is end of 2018 and the beginning of 2019 years. But we can see that other years there are also some spikes when this diet was really popular. And of course, some filters that you can use is geography, is a time period, time frame, categories, and web search. Of course, if you are willing to sell to US customers, you should look for trends only in US, but you also can find how this search term was worldwide, and we can see that there are also the same spikes, so that's international trend for Mediterranean diet. It can be also very useful to go to trending searches, and here you can find daily search trends or even real-time search trends for some topics that are really popular right now. You can also choose the country where you want to look for the trends. And here, yes, of course, most of these trends are connected with some popular persons, with some sportsmen or some other kind of stars, and if we are talking about print-on-demand business, it's not safe to make such kind of designs, but sometimes you can find also some really popular topics, really popular trends that will also be useful for you too, especially some political trends when there are election times. So you can find these topics here and use it in your design creation too. But what I like more is using this search bar and finding the popularity of some trend or some niche. For example, if we will go with this diet search term, we can not only find the interest over time, but here we can find related topics and related queries, which can be really useful. You can choose rising or top related queries, and in rising we can find some pagan diet. I don't even know what is pagan diet, but it is going to be really popular in these days, or paleo diet food list. But if we will change to top related queries, we can find keto diet or Mediterranean diet, and of course if we go to this new trends, for example this pagan diet, we can find that it isn't something very new, but it is going to be popular in this period, and it's the top spike for a pagan diet for the last year. And of course we can then dive deeper for this search term and try to find some ideas what we also can do. For example, even for print-on-demand business, we can find some designed for vegan diet, if there is something available right now, and is, we can see there is only 10 search results for now. And of course it is working not only with some diet themes, but also about everything. Another good tool that you can use here is a comparison. You can compare your search term with any other term, for example with this keto diet, which is really popular in that theme. And as we can see, yes, ketodiene is going lower and lower over the time, but vegan diet isn't really popular right now, so in comparison, there will not be a lot of search volume for vegan diet. And you can add up to 5 different searches to your graph, and here we can see that in the middle will be Mediterranean diet, and we also can look how it changes over the different periods of time. It is not always a good idea to search only for trendy searches, because it is often works for a short period of time, and if you will compare it with some evergreen topics, you can find that evergreen searches can be better than something really trendy, or we can also find holiday trends that are going to be every year, but only 1 month a year it will be popular. For example, if we will search for something evergreen like coffee, we can see that over the past 5 years there wasn't a lot of different spikes. And if we compare, for example, with St. Patrick's Day, which is a good holiday search, yes, we have some spikes, really good spikes, but this search wasn't popular at all any other time of the year. Of course, it's up to you which designs you wish to create, and which trendy searches you want to look for, but as for me, I always make some trendy designs, but I want them to be not more than 10% of the whole number of my designs, because if I have mostly evergreen designs for evergreen searches, I will have a stable sales, and I will have some additional bonus sales for new trends, and it can give me some good months. But even in months when I can find any interesting trend, I will be with a good cash flow, with a good sales, so it will not affect me much. It was a short video about using Google Trends for searching for good niches. Subscribe to this channel. We are talking here about print-on-demand business, and I often film some videos about design ideas. So see you in another videos on this channel, and I wish you a good sales. Bye.